Well, in this part, it will be installing tape transport back. And there will be a couple interesting things we need to do to make this happen. First of all, get it back in. Here. Now we have to fix it. So leave two screws, two here and two on the bottom. So this one will transfer ground. So we'll add this ground wire. Yeah. It will go on top, so it will be easier. So one screw here, and another one down here. Okay, then two wires, let me see this, mix of wires, this one will get up there, okay, there's two screws down here. Okay, then let's connect wires to the power supply control board. This was the one. This was for the capstan motor. Have it. Now this is the head wires. Okay, this one. Well, you should go around. Here, so this is the head wires. It gets into this hole. Okay, two. bunch of wires, let's fix it here by this large piece. Okay, and the one large into position encoder. Okay, done with this guy. Now going on top here, this part. Screws for this part. Done. Now we have to solder these guys back. I still see it. Let me make it closer for you. Here, this one gets here. Okay. This one. And it's in the other. Done. Next, this connector. It gets into this board here. Let me sit closer. Connect it. Okay, and the last part is a switch for the standby mode record play. It's a bit messy. Need to get it into position. Done. So come on, no. Door open. maybe it's wrong position of tape transfer, so it would not allow to open the door. Now, let's see, let's turn it on, let's see if it will stay into the proper position itself. Gets into the playback mode. Let's see there. I believe I connected everything. Capstan motor works. Reel motor doesn't work. Counter works. Okay, I need to find what's wrong with this guy to continue my search. I will get back to you later.